In today's video, I'm going to show you another feature of the pass-through API that is going to allow us to apply pass-through to a specific surfaces. This is going to be helpful for experiences where we don't want to apply the pass-through to the entire screen. Instead, we may want to apply it to specific objects. I did exactly that in a demo that I created that I submitted to GitHub, where I'm applying the pass-through to a specific game objects on the screen. I'm also randomizing which ones get the pass-through and which ones not. So let's jump into Unity and start looking at it. All right, guys, so what I'm gonna show you today is a scene that I added to my Oculus pass-through demos, which is available in GitHub. So the way that this is gonna work is I have the instructions in here. So if you press the A button on the Oculus controller, it's gonna either set it to no pass-through, where we're not gonna be able to see anything, or we're gonna set it to user-defined pass-through, which is what you saw at the beginning of the video, and also reconstructor pass-through, which means that the entire scene is going to have pass-through. And then the A action is going to do it basically in a random way. So it's going to select certain tiles to apply the surface pass-through, and then other tiles won't have pass-through. And then if you press B on the controller, it's basically gonna do it to every single tile. I wanted to do that just to do something a little bit different. So if we look at the hierarchy in here, you're gonna see that I have the surface projection manager. And I tried to do this a little bit different, where I didn't have to create prefabs dynamically during runtime, but unfortunately, and I'll show you why that is, I had to do it this way. But I have basically a user-defined prefab that I can apply, and also a reconstructed prefab, which are going to be located on the resources. So we're going to go ahead and associate those, and then also the user-defined. And then the tiles root, all I'm using that for is basically to be able to find every single one of these tiles. So if you look at one of these tiles, that way I can, you know, I can determine which tile I'm going to apply a pass-through to. And then if you look at this component in here, it has the surface pass-through tile, which I'm going to show you the code for. And also, if we look at the component that is inside, it's going to basically going to be the mesh, which is going to be a plane, and it's rotated at negative 90 degrees. That way we can see the pass-through texture as we, you know, as we apply this. Otherwise, if we leave it at zero, it's gonna be flat and we won't be able to see it. And then I also scale it to 0.05 on X, Y, and Z. And then it also has a mesh renderer, and then the quad outline that it has is that texture that you see is only transparent with a little bit of opacity on the edges. So now let's go ahead and take a look at the surface projection manager. I didn't want to code everything from scratch because it did take me some time, otherwise this video will be too long. But I'm gonna walk you through the entire thing, and then we'll do some coding as well, which is the part that I think you need to learn. So at the beginning, all I'm doing is just getting basically a prefab for the pass-through layer, which is gonna be the user-defined. This is the one that we are going to specifically tell the pass-through layer which game objects we're gonna have a pass-through to, right? So we need the prefab, and we also need the actual game object that I'm gonna be creating. The same thing with the reconstructed prefab and also the game object. And then these are just two references so that I know, okay, which components have the OVR pass-through layer, one for the user-defined, one for the reconstructed, and then my tiles rule is the serializable field, which is the one that, you know, determines, okay, where are all the different tiles? And then this is so that I can determine, okay, what do I need to apply by default? So by default, there's basically nothing that has been applied. So I have this reconstructed pass-through toggle that I can set to on and off, depending on, you know, the state. If I am doing, by default, it's going to basically set the toggle surface to randomize tiles to false, which means that it's gonna go through here and it's gonna say, okay, have I applied a reconstructed pass-through, which, you know, by default is false, it's gonna set it to true. And then it's going to say, okay, I haven't applied a reconstructed pass-through, so I'm gonna apply it to the entire scene. This is the part that we actually need to code it. I'm gonna show you how we can do that. And then if I already selected reconstructed pass-through, meaning that we want to do a user-defined pass-through, that's when we have to say, okay, we're gonna change the projection, and we're going to be adding all different tiles that we need to project to. It sounds more complicated than it is, but I'll show you how that works. And then that's what's gonna happen here on default. I'm gonna get basically all the different tiles that have this script. And then by default, I'm just going to be calling this method. That way we can have, you know, at least one pass-through with a camera on it, because I'm creating the OVR camera rig dynamically at runtime. So, you know, by default it's gonna execute that, but if we wanna toggle it with the controller, we're gonna go into the update and I'm gonna say, okay, if I'm pressing, you know, the A button, I'm going to basically toggle the surface type and I'm gonna change all the tiles. I'm gonna set into true so that way we can get randomized tiles by default. But if I press B, it's basically gonna say, okay, you know what? I don't want to randomize the tiles. I'm just going to set them all to have the pass-through layer on them, meaning that we're gonna be able to see through the physical world on all of those. And then basically calls this method, and then this is the one that we need to implement. This is a not so that I can, you know, we can toggle back and forth. The enable projection surface type, I ended up doing it this way because we needed to create these game objects at runtime. And that is because the OVR pass-through layer has a bug. And I don't know if it's a bug or a feature, but they say in here specifically that there is an issue where, you know, you can't really change this at runtime. And they're gonna be working on that. So I tried to change it at runtime, it didn't work. So what I ended up doing to make it work is I'm creating everything from scratch, right? I'm creating an instance of the actual reconstructed, basically it's the OVR camera rig with the OVR pass-through layer in it. And then I set it to reconstructed by default. So that's basically what this is doing. And then if I'm using a user-defined one, which is the other one that is on the top of the script, then I just create an instance and then I just get the OVR pass-through layer. So if you go into Unity here and you look at the prefabs that I have in here, these are these objects. I'm creating these objects on, you know, on during runtime. And then the reconstructor has a reconstructor property on it and the user defined has that on it. Okay, so the first thing that we need to do here is we need to tell it, okay, what kind of projection we're gonna be doing. Well, this is set to true, so I need to set it to reconstructor. And then on this one, I need to set it to user defined, which means that we're going to be telling the OVR pass-through layer which tiles we're gonna be projecting to. So I'm gonna change in this one to user-defined. And then on the app projection tiles, I have a component in here, a method in here, where I tell it to do that. So if we call that in here, we're gonna be able to say, it's gonna tell you, do we wanna add the basically projections? Well, we do wanna add them, so I'm just gonna set it to true. And the reason why I call that add projection, that should probably be called like should add projection. This is so that, you know, we can either remove or we can add. So if I say true, I'm gonna say, you know, I need to add projection. If I set it to false, that means that we need to remove the projection, and I'll show you the implementation of that. But on this one, I'm just gonna say, let's go ahead and do it this way so we can see what each argument is. And then in this case, we can tell it, okay, do we wanna randomize it? Do we don't wanna randomize it? And if you remember, what we can do is we can just pass in the value that I got from the update method. So I'm just gonna go ahead and pass in that value. I don't need to set it explicitly. And then once we do that, it's gonna say, okay, I need to create the OVR camera rig, which has the OVR pass-through layer and basically anything that it needs. And then once I do that, I'm gonna start adding all the projection tiles. So I'm just gonna go ahead and go into this method, which is in here. And this is where we get into the implementation of the pass-through tiles. So, you know, we did add projection, so we're gonna be calling this method. Let's go ahead and go into that. And then all these needs, there's a couple of components that the OVR pass-through layer is gonna need. In order for us to tell it, okay, you need to render the pass-through layer to that specific mesh, which in our case is gonna be a plane. So we need a mesh filter for that, and I also need the outline mesh renderer because we need to tell it, okay, do we wanna enable the material or do we wanna disable the material? If we're seeing the pass-through layer, we wanna make sure we disable the material so we can see the actual layer rendering on the screen. And I'm just basically getting here, and I also have a private bool to determine if we already added the projection or not. That way we don't try to remove something if it hasn't been added. And this is something that I use for randomization. I'll show you how that works. And then I'm just getting basically reference to those two different components. And then this is the app projection method that we saw on the other area. And all I'm saying is, okay, if I wanna randomize it, I'm gonna get a number from 0 to 1. 2 is exclusive, so it won't be included. But if I get a 1, I'm gonna add the projection. If I get a 0, I won't add the projection. I'll just set it to, you know, I'll just set this outline to true. That way I won't see the pass-through API projection on it, but I will see the actual material. And then if we don't wanna randomize it, it'll just add the projection to basically everything. And then this is the part that we need to implement, and this is also the part that we need to implement. I left comments in here so that you know what we need to do. And all I have to do is just say, okay, surface, I need to call the projection manager. and it's a singleton, and I need to call the pass-through API layer. And there's gonna be two methods that we're gonna need. One of them is gonna be the surface geometry. So this tells the OVR pass-through layer that we're gonna be adding this specific surface to the, basically to the API layer. And so what we need to do here, we're gonna tell the system, okay, what is it that we're gonna be adding? So we need to basically add the projection mesh filter. So I'm gonna go ahead and add that. And then we're gonna add the game object. There's also a property in here that tells it to update the transform on every frame. So I'm gonna set that to true. And if you go in here, you can also look at the documentation in here. It'll tell you specifically what it does. If you set the update transform to true, the overlay will update the transform on the surface mesh on every frame. Otherwise, it'll just be at the beginning. So this is helpful. Like if you're moving the game object around, you can set it to true and you know it'll be updated correctly. If you set it to false, then if you don't set it, it'll just be, I believe it'll be false by default. I mean, that kind of makes sense. And then, so once we have the pass-through surface layer, that means that we're gonna be able to see the pass-through on this specific tile. And then if we're removing it, we're basically gonna do the same thing. I'm just gonna go ahead and grab that and then just call a different method. It's gonna be remove. And then we're just gonna be removing the geometry. So we'll just remove basically the same thing that we added, as long as we have added the surface projection. The reason why I do this is because this is randomized. So in that case is what we don't want to add it. We just change the material. We want to make sure we don't remove it if it hasn't been added. So that's one way that I did it so that things, you know, don't break. So it's basically everything that we need to do here in order for that to work. So let me show you how this looks by running this in the Oculus Quest 2. All right, guys, so I had this built and I did a recording as well. So let me show you how this works. So I'm gonna enable it and you can see that some of the tiles are rendering the pass-through, just like I show you in the code. You can also pass my hand through some of the tiles and you can see how they are specifically just rendering when they need to. In this case, I'm pressing a different button and now all the different tiles are rendering the pass-through because we added that randomize option to the code, and see how everything, you know, everything works and looks. You can see how the hand works. And I really like how the digital, basically we're in a digital world and all of a sudden we go into a partial pass-through API world. And it just gives you the, you know, the power of being able to be selective on what things you want to render. You can use this like if you wanted to per se have maybe a window and you can see through that window, or you want to have a specific thing rendering in real life versus not rendering in real life. So this is everything that I honestly wanted to show you today. If you want to make sure that you follow me in Twitter, because I'm going to be making, you know, more prototypes about this in Twitter, and also make sure you download the repo in GitHub, and because I'm going to be pushing this as soon as I'm done with this video. So if you guys have any other questions about this, please let me know in the comments. Thank you.